Structural organization animals. The first connective tissue we are going to talk about is called cartilage. So cartilage is a specialized connective tissue. It is a specialized connective tissue. Specialized connective tissue. In specialized connective tissues, we talk about cartilage, bones, and blood. Cartilage is one of the specialized connective tissues. And this cartilage, its origin is mesodermal. It's mesodermal in origin. All connective tissues are mesodermal in origin. And connective tissue is the most abundant type of tissue in body of complex animals. And this is specialized connective tissue and it's mesodermal in origin. Let's come to cartilage now. Cartilage has some cells. So it has some cells. The cells of cartilage are called as chondrocytes. Chondrocytes. Chondro is something related to cartilage. Cytes means cells. It has chondrocytes. It also has some immature type of chondrocytes. These are called chondroblasts. It also has chondroblasts. These are the young type of these chondrocytes. Chondroblasts. Cytes means the real cells. Blast means these are the young form of the chondrocytes and they eventually turn into chondrocytes. So these are the two cells of cartilage, chondrocytes and chondroblasts. It has matrix as well. Cartilage has matrix as well. This matrix is rubbery. It's rubbery and in this matrix there are some fibers. So every connective tissue has some fibers and these fibers are two. We talk about two major fibers. The first one is called collagen and elastin. Collagen is the most abundant protein in the human body. So collagen and elastin. Collagen is formed from fibrochondrocytes and elastin is formed from elastin chondrocytes. So there has to be some cells which produce these, like collagen and elastin. There should be some cells which secrete collagen and elastin. These are called fibroblasts. So we can add one more cell here, fibroblasts. So the cells are chondrocytes, chondroblasts, and fibroblasts. Matrix is rubbery. Fibers are collagen and elastin. Now if you look at the structure of cartilage or the inner structure of cartilage, it somewhat looks like this. So this membrane here, this one, outer membrane is called as, this one, is called as perichondrium. Perichondrium. Peri means something that surrounds, like it covers something. Peri means like around. Chondrium means something related to cartilage. So it's called perichondrium. And the cells, so if this is the perichondrium, the cells here, these cells, nucleus as well, these cells are called as the chondroblasts. So these cells are called chondroblasts and this is the nucleus of the chondroblast. Now these are the normal cartilage cells, the chondrocytes. These are the chondrocytes. Now these chondrocytes can be in 1, 2s and 3s. They can be in bundles like this. So there can be 1, 2 and 3 as well. So these are normal contour sides. And there is a little gap or there is a little covering which surrounds these cells, be it 1, be it 2 or be it 3. There is a little covering that surrounds these cells. These cells are called, this covering is called as, so this one is called as lacuna. This lacuna is like a cavity or depression. It's like a little cavity or depression, and it is basically a fluid filled space or unfilled space. So it just looks, it's called lacuna. And we also have fibers. So matrix is rubbery, we told, and it has fibers which are called as collagen and elastin. Which one is collagen in this? Usually collagen is not branched, it is usually in bundles. So this is called collagen fibers or collagen proteins. So this is usually in bundles and it's not branched. Elastin is usually not in bundles and it is branched. So elastin, it provides flexibility and elasticity. So this is elastin, collagen, the fibers. We also have fibroblasts. These are the cells that secrete elastin and collagen, all the fibers. So these are cells with long processes are called fibroblasts. So these are the cells that secrete these fibers, fibroblasts. They are usually have long processes. They look like amoeba-like cells. Next, we'll take up the three different types of cartilage which are present. Three types of cartilage based on what type of matrix is present in it. So the three cartilage are, the first type of cartilage is called hyaline cartilage, hyaline. The next one is called fibrocartilage. The next one is called elastin cartilage. Now, as the name tells us, fibro and elastin, we can guess what might the matrix look like. But hyaline, what does hyaline mean? Hyaline cartilage, it has, its matrix is glass-like. So it has glass-like matrix. That means the matrix do not have fibers. It does not have fibers. It doesn't contain any fibers. Maybe it just may contain one bundle of, let's say, collagen and some elastin. That's it. Because it's more rubbery and glass-like matrix is there. It's transparent mostly. So it's a hyaline cartilage. It doesn't contain any fibers. It just contains one or two. And the places, the locations where we can find hyaline cartilage is, it can be hyaline cartilage can be found at the tip of long bones. So if we draw a bone here, so if this is the bone, the tip of this bones here, somewhere over here, the hyaline cartilage will be present. So it's found at the tip of the long bones. It's also found at the larynx part. at the larynx or the voice box. It's also present in the tracheal rings. Okay, so it's found at the tip of the long bones, larynx, and tracheal rings. Now we will talk about fibrocartilage. Fibrocartilage, as the name suggests, the matrix has a lot of fibers. What are those fibers? It's collagen mostly. So fibrocartilage mostly its matrix contains collagen. Matrix contains bundles and bundles of collagen, so we can tell it's more rough and it has more collagen like thing. So collagen fibers, so the matrix contains collagen, maybe one or two elastin, but mostly it contains this collagen. And we'll look at the locations where it is found. So it's found in the intervertebral discs. It's also found at the pubic symphysis or symphysis. So pubic symphysis and intervertebral discs are the places where fibrocartilage is found. Next, elastin. As the name suggests, again, matrix contains more of elastin fiber. And what does this kind of elastin fiber do? Elastin fiber mostly gives flexibility and elasticity to the organ or the part where it is found. So elastin can be found at the tip of nose or the nose tip. It can also be found in epiglottis and eopina means somewhere over here. So if you try to stretch it regains its shape. It's because of this elastin fiber. And also at the tip of the nose, epiglottis and eopina. Epiglottis is the flap like thing which prevents the food going into the tracheal part. So this is elastin, fibrocartilage, elastin cartilage, fibrocartilage, and hyaline cartilage. So hyaline cartilage is glass-like matrix. Fibrocartilage is matrix. Matrix contains most of collagen, and elastin cartilage its matrix contains more of elastin. This is about cartilage.